Well, hello, welcome back. We are in Larnaca, of course, and we have just had a very, very exciting start to our week with the women's skeet competition. It's still saying 21 degrees, but it's getting cooler as we get into the evening. And bit cool in the sun, it's okay, but we do have that breeze that makes life a little bit difficult for the athletes. We heard that from Danka Bartikova, the gold medalist in the women's competition, of course. Same for everybody. A bit of a luck of the draw as to whether you get a gust of wind putting the targets out of the normal flight path, but we will see how it goes. We've got eight men now lining up. Two ranking matches, of course, and our first ranking match. We'll see Egypt, Finland, Cyprus and Germany. And, well, we'll get to the first two. But a big cheer for this man here, the local man, Georgios Akilios, the man from Limassol. Born in London, though. He could have represented Great Britain, I guess, but very much a Cypriot and a proud Cypriot as well. Also, Sven Korte of Germany, the 33-year-old soldier from Ibbenbüren. We also saw Ashmi Mahelva, of course, a very experienced athlete, the Egyptian Itu Kalionen, also in this one, in the second final. Eric Bettini, the Italian Ben Llewellyn, also around in the mix, qualifying sixth in the end. The 28-year-old, a mixed team gold medalist, of course, silver in Nicosia back in 2016. Clive Farrugia, the Maltese athlete, 31 years of age, best in the World Cup, was 11th in Rabat this year, so he's in something of a decent run of form as well. And Dustin Taylor is the last man into the lineup, but by no means least, of course. If you look at his actual picture on the athlete's biography in the IWSF, you'll see him with a cowboy hat on, looking very much the proper American. Marian Caparano of Romania takes center stage. Those are the eight, two ranking matches, of course. Willie Grill in the stands watching on. The Secretary General of the IWSF had a busy day. He's always busy. So the ranking match number one is coming up. Test firing first off. It's Germany, Cyprus, Finland, Egypt, Korte, Akilios, Kalionien, and Mahelba. That's Mahelba, the 32-year-old from Alexandria. Man who has a world championship from Osijek last year, of course, you may remember. A couple of World Cup goals, including Nicosia last year when it was a bit chilly in the other shooting range in the country. Got a couple of World Cup goals, Leonardo in 21 as well. And a three-time African champion. There he is. He's a no-nonsense, get-on-with-it kind of athlete.
Mm-hmm.
just the test fire, getting used to the conditions. There's quite a bit to get used to. It's the turbines, the wind turbines above us, are just moving around a little bit more than they were, a bit faster than they were. Underway then with the German, and underway well, Stefan Korte. European Championship silver in 2016. Kyrgios, 42 years of age now. He's been to 5 Olympic Games. First was in Sydney. Came 5th in Beijing, almost onto the podium there. Not quite. I wonder if he'll be in Paris next year. Of course, World Championships in Baku coming up. Another chance to get quota places, as well as the Continental Championships. And a good start from these men at the moment. Itu Kallionen. 24 years of age. Youngster, really. The man from Lopi. Is up. Mahalba starts well. And there's our first red. It took a while, didn't it? It took a while. And Mahalba is the one who's just a little behind. Coach is watching on. Job mostly done. It's not just the technical aspects. Coaches are also very often the team managers. Saw Jay Waldron in sorting out, making sure transport was okay for the flights back for their street athletes. The trap athletes, I think, have finally made it after that epic journey. Good from court. Fist pumps, order of the day from the coaches, just get that little bit of encouragement to their charges. Now Mahalba. Well, one behind after the first station. Not two behind after the second one, so he does well. It's high quality in the conditions. We saw a lot of double misses from in the women's competition. Some spectators on the wall, some on the seats, some up at the clubhouse. Has started really well, the 33-year-old. And he has started excellently. Kyrgios. All local hopes on his shoulders. Coach watching on, but he's the man whose charge is everybody is hoping here. All Cypriots with their fingers crossed. He has started well. He's so experienced now. 6 World Cup golds for Kyrgios, but slightly different story for Kallionen. Miss from him, first for the Finn. looking to better his fourth place. He's done that twice as Kallion and Nicosia last year, Lahti in 2019 on home soil. Had the old coat on jacket out then as well. It was a chilly old September, I think it was, in Lahti in 2019. Lovely place though. Malva with another miss. Not going the way of the Egyptian at the moment. Round we go. Remember, 20 targets before we lose our first. Fourth place decided after one more go around. The German, all eyes, no blinking or concentration. But, it's a tough mentally for these athletes. You've always got to be switched on. No target. I'll have to reset. One came out, the other one didn't. All part and parcel of the athletes' travails, I think it's fair to say. And there again. It's the high house. Just asking the referee if they could see and get one out and make sure it's working properly. We seem to be okay. Let's keep our fingers crossed. Goes up. After all that, the one when it did come out was missed from the high house. Nice from the Cypriot. No reds against his name as of yet. I hope I haven't had a commentator's curse on him. Yep, there you go. Inevitably. And that's one from the low house, so this time not the one you see so often missed. Chance to come level with Kallionis Kallios. And does. Nicely done. Well, Mahalba, a little bit behind where he would like to be, that's for sure. But four here, and he will be within touching distance. And the pressure is on. Took his time. But spent it wisely. Station four is next up. This time the targets will come in a different order. They'll look at the low house first. And there we go. Second red from the German. That's two out of three he's missed. After a really good start. And a bit of pressure. And a miss from Kallios as well. I wonder if the conditions are just getting a little tricky out there, because station four should be a breeze. That's nicely done. And he will, from being level with Korte and Kallios, will just edge into the lead. Now Mahalba. And a miss from him, and the shoulders go down a little bit. assistant referees, the line referees, all in agreement. And well, Kalliounen has done well. One ahead of Kouter Akilios, and we come round to station number five, and this will decide who takes fourth place in this first ranking match. Took a long time to get them away, but was more than capable of doing that. Oh, and again, very quickly shot this time. Not much distance between the one from the low house and the high house being dispatched. So pressure a bit more on the others now. Korte will certainly be going through. Five more than Mahelba. Mahelba will be watching how these others do. And a miss from the low house. That reverse. Not a disaster for Akilios. Kalliounen was leading going into this station. That's nicely done. He's looking in great form, the youngster. 24 years of age and quite happy. Thank you very much. Well, not much Mahelba can do. He's the lowest bid number. 17 it is. Akilios with the same number of hits, but it is the bib number that does for Ashmi Mahelba, the Egyptian, who has a couple of World Cup titles to his name, will not be adding it here. And he is the first to bow out fourth place in this first ranking match. So then, three left, only two will go through. And the German gets us underway. One more time around, and we will see who will make it through. Want a good score, of course, to get yourself a good bib number in the final. And there is a double miss, a double miss. Well, the referee's hand, one hand went up, and then the other slowly, slowly, like a torture. Oh, well, not a disaster for Korte, not a disaster as of yet. Akilios will only be one ahead if he bats both of these, and he doesn't. So all of a sudden, Korte in a little bit of danger here, but Kalliounen, a real chance to eke a lead out here. Couldn't quite nab that last one, but he's looking in good nick, and he's looking in a good place as well. Who will fall by the wayside? We're getting close to finding out. In the background, I think you saw the windmilling arms of Eric Pettini, an Italian, warming up for our next ranking match. Really important that you don't stumble here on station four. Two puffs of pink powder And that's what you want to see. Dali Onan. Well, he is moving on nicely and continues to be two ahead. Has the advantage heading into station number five. But you can't be complacent. We've seen a couple of double misses. One from Quarter, of course, and also in the women's we saw quite a few, including the one that meant that Claretta Chadid had to settle for bronze and not at least silver. Anyway, here we go. Last action from this first ranking match. Oh, he has done very well there. Achilleos needs all of these to take it to a shoot-off. Assuming Kalionen overhauls their total. Done! There's a miss. Oh, dearie me. Well, there's a possibility, isn't there? It'd have to be a really bad day at the office for Kalionen, for Achilleos to go through, and what a shame for the local fans. Very nearly had a woman in the women's competition, but just could not quite make it. And so it's not a day of celebration. A little look over his shoulder from Kalionen. He's not going to argue too much. It is Achilleos who takes the third place and is ruled out. What a disappointment. He was in a good place, but just stumbled towards the end. Here's confirmation. Finland and Germany. Kalionen and Korte are the two who will qualify. 27 and 26 are decent totals. We'll see if that gets them the top bibs in the medal match. We have to find out what happens in ranking match number two, and that is coming next. We'll be right back. So then the second ranking match, we've had our test fire. We're underway with Dustin Taylor of the United States, with a 30-year-old from Fort Benning in the Army. Home is Liberty. And you couldn't get all as all-American as him. His hobbies: hunting, fishing and shooting. Well, Clyde Ferrugia of Malta does have one miss from... he arrived late for reporting, so his first shot will be a miss. Despite the fact he bagged it. And our jury member in charge just reminding the referee, who has other worries on his mind, that is the case. So a miss despite a good start. It's getting a little dark compared to earlier. Sun's gone behind clouds. It goes behind the hills as well at some point. I can't quite see from where we are whether that's happened or not. Anyway, it's a little darker. The lights on the scoreboard are lighting up a wee bit. Same for everybody, of course. Look at that. Per Moen. A look of a sage about him. Ben Lewenin. Silver in Nicosia. Bronze in Changwon. 6 years apart. Miss for Llewellyn from the high house on the reverse. Here's Pettini, 25 years of age. Udine is his hometown. Team Skeet World Cup gold in Changwon last year. That's his only medal. Changwon last year was also his best at fifth. Individually, Andrea Benelli is something's being pointed out. Meanwhile, his charge has another two to get away. No, there is a problem with another no target. Possibly not hearing his call. Sometimes you've got a very quiet call. Microphone is on, the light is showing that. He does very well, given the delay, really well indeed, to bag the four. Round to four we go. He looks chilled, doesn't he? The wind has gone up, the sun has gone down. And I'm bringing an extra coat tomorrow. Mixed team, of course, hope you can join us for that. It'd be great to have your company. Waiting behind, just following the move of Taylor, who dusts off another two. So here's the man from Malta. 14th, his best here in Larnaca last year in the European Championships, best in the World Cup, as we mentioned, 11th. So he's been there or thereabouts, and I guess just looking to take the step up. Llewellyn, looking good. Just one behind Dustin Taylor. In the battle to join Sven Korte and Itu Kallionen in the final. Pettini is looking good as well. So it's tight, but it is the Maltese athlete at the moment who is struggling, and the sun comes out. Round we go then, for the first time to station number five Kay Waldron, cheerful as ever, mischievous as ever, but not when it comes to looking after his athletes. He will be pumped, no doubt, on Instagram tonight if there's a medal for this gentleman here. Turned the big 3-0. It's in his prime. That team gold in Rabat. Massive haul from the American team in Rabat. So Jet dispatches the first two, no problem at all. Needs a few flawless stations, doesn't he, to keep himself in touch. And that's not going to help. Lohax is the one that was missed. Llewellyn up, and Llewellyn with a miss. Taylor looking pretty good. No misses so far. Drawing away from the rest. Took his time on the low house. Had already missed the one from the high house. So a couple of misses from Llewellyn puts him down in trouble. Twenty targets before we lose our fourth place athlete, remember. Patini in the lengthening shadows. Weak spring sunshine, I think it's fair to say. Italian coach is smiling, that's always good to see. Andrea Benelli. And that's what it looks like after 10 targets. United States, Italy, the powerhouses ahead of Malta and Great Britain. Back to station number three then. Here's Dustin Taylor. Hand has gone up. There's the first blemish on Taylor's record. That one for the high is really travelling. Such great coordination from these athletes. It really is something to behold. Now what can Aludia do here? Llewellyn, all of a sudden, after that double miss on station five, is in for his sights, I imagine. I feel he has a chance. Oh, not after that, perhaps. A little shake of the shrug of the shoulders. Just the one miss, but it's enough to put Llewellyn ahead of Farrugia in the scramble to stay in. Patini looks a particularly good athlete, doesn't he, despite his young age. Again, like the United States, a real stable of shotgun athletes, particularly in trap, of course. Oh. And he perhaps just snatched at the last one. And Patini is also one in the red. 13 apiece for Taylor and Patini. Llewellyn on 10, Ferrugia on 9. So, Taylor with those baggy pants. Very relaxed look, I feel. Some are so intense. He has the focus, but he is hopefully still relaxed and focused despite that no target in this middle station. To reset, get himself back in into the zone, and here he is. Been a tricky station today with the weather and the conditions. Certainly can't afford to miss too many days. Missed another one. Doesn't look like it's going to be his day. World ranked in the top 20. He's been consistent. Llewellyn adds to the pain. Now Patini needs to keep himself clear of Llewellyn in the battle to go into the final. Just checking, making sure he's right for the targets. Well, there's a pause. I try and make sure these targets are coming out correctly. Just trying to work out what the problem is. I'm trying to look at my colleagues on the left-hand side. It is a problem with the high house, as you can see. Technicians, oh no, they've been directed to the low house. They've gone to the wrong house. We've all done that from time to time. Well, we have a slight delay here in this second ranking match. Conversation is going on. I have asked an official who's not entirely sure. There's some more clays being dispatched to the low house. Perhaps we've run out. I very much doubt we've run out of clays. Doesn't happen very often. Whatever happens, these athletes just have to keep calm, carry on. Well, they are loading. They are perhaps. We're getting low on clays. Never ever seen that in a final before, but you never know, that might be it. Beautiful day, sun just about to dip behind the hills, which are dotted with wind turbines. You see the clubhouse at the top, a great view over all the ranges from there. Our dignitaries are down on the posh seats at the front, and the coaches are in a ringside seat as well. There's activity in the low house, swarming around it like bees around a honeypot. I've just inquired to my left. Little technical problem is all I could get out of them. But the low house seems to be working again. Whether that's just because they've loaded it up or not is a matter for conjecture. Doesn't matter. We're ready to go. Yeah, it's getting a little bit darker. Amazing what our cameras can do, though, given half a chance. But the certainly bright lights on the countdown clock on the scoreboard. Where are we? Back to Patini, who did very well. That was a long delay. Round we go to station number five. So someone's going to be exiting at this point. It looks like it might be the Maltese athlete after missing a fair few. Three out of the last four has put him in a poor position. Not so for Dustin Taylor. He is in sparkling form. Just the one miss from him, just the one miss from Patini. Llewellyn struggling to keep up with him, but he'll be hoping that if he can just stay in. Another miss from Taylor. Certainly we'll go through to the next phase, come what may. Virginie's all four here. And just, I guess, keep his fingers crossed. Wonder whether that late reporting attachment of a one missed target will make a difference. Nicely done. Nicely done. Well, that's a good finish if it is to be a finish, but Llewellyn has a bit of work to do here. He is a lower bib number. He needs three. Hitting those targets in quick order. Just one here then to get him through, but obviously he needs as many as possible to try and get into the last two. And he bags them both. Nicely done. Two behind Taylor. Now then, Patini, who has a chance to sneak into the lead here. Very distinctive design to the stock of that shotgun, and it's done the job. Into first place he goes, and we have our first confirmation of fourth place. Our first person to leave is the Maltese athlete Clive Ferrugia. Not going to be a podium for him, not going to be a final for him. He takes his place. We have 10 more targets before we find out who is going to miss out and which two are going to go through. At the moment, you put your money on Patini and Taylor, wouldn't you? Back round at station number three, Taylor. In the shirt sleeves, you know, the two athletes left in, got the long sleeves on. Made of tough stuff, this man. It's shot. The other one a little bit too quickly, perhaps. And that is another miss. Nothing to panic about if you're the coach. Llewellyn, though, has a chance, perhaps, to close the gap a bit more. Never out of it until you have to take your seat, are you? Ooh, and a miss there. A miss there. So he stays two behind Taylor. And Bettini, well, can really put clear water between him and the rest. Couple here would be very useful, thank you very much. He is getting a little bit gloomy out there. Final will be interesting. So then, round we go. Station number four, getting close to the denouement of this second ranking match. Taylor and Bettini look like the two who are going to go through, but you never know. We've had a couple of double misses, adding to the drama of the men's and women's competition. Miss from Taylor. And a miss from Llewellyn. He's been given opportunities, hasn't he? Yeah. Well, whispering something to himself. I'm not sure it's particularly complimentary as he walked away. And Bettini just keeps on hitting, looking good. Little smile from the Italian coach. Why not? Just increase the lead. No one changing place. Llewellyn with a lot of work to do here. Needs to hit all four and someone to have a bad day at the office. If I were a betting man, which I'm not, I would suggest it's not going to happen, but you never know. You never know. And there is a miss from Taylor, but he is through. So Llewellyn, this is all a bit academic. Can he finish in style though? Missing the one from the low house, not his day. So it is Taylor and Bettini, but the higher the score, the better your bib number's going to be in the final. A couple here, and he will have bib number one. Oh, it's beautifully done. Just wonderful from the Italian. Not so good from Llewellyn. He'll have another shot at it, I am sure. A little pat on the back from the Italian coach as he wanders away. And this is how it has finished. Wonderful from Bettini. Goodness me. And not bad from Justin Taylor either. So Taylor and Bettini will progress to the final. Korte and Kallioninen await them. And that is coming up, the medal match, in just a couple of minutes' time. Doesn't matter.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue with the medal match, the skipman individual event. The four finalists will participate in the medal match with big number four, representing the United States of America, Dustin Taylor.
Here we go then, medal match for the men's skeet competition. The World Cup here in Larnaca. The clouds have come over from the left-hand side over our left shoulder. It's getting a bit dark. The lights are shining brighter than they were before. But we are hoping for a very bright few minutes here in the final. Dustin Taylor, Sven Kort, Eetu Kallioinen. The young Finn. And looked very good, didn't he? The 24-year-old in his semi-final. And Eric Pettini looked even better. Another youngster. At 25 years of age. One medal to his name. Gold at Changwon last year. But that was a team competition. Real chance here to make a name for himself. And he certainly has already.
And referee in charge, Mr. Gabriel Assad from France.
Those are our officials. Those four are our finalists. Let's see what happens here. Will it be yet another United States triumph, or can Italy lay down the gauntlet once again? Well, he swept everyone before him, didn't he? Pettini, that's why he's got bib number one. That's why he's top of the rankings before we get underway. First two shots in this final are green. Pettini, watched on by Andreas Benelli. I don't know why he's got these shades on. It's not that bright out there, unless they're prescription. Flags go up either side. Hand goes up from the referee. First miss. That one from the low house from Pettini. Now Kallioinen, 24 years of age, youngest in this final. Couple of 20-year-olds, couple of 30, those in their 30s. Pietro Genga will be very pleased with this young man. The man from Lopi. Good start from the Finn. Now the German, Sven Kort. Second in that first ranking match, Axel Kramer watching on. Another one of those who always feels, he always you look and feel, he's not enjoying watching this. He'll enjoy, I was going to say, greens all the way, but there was a miss from the high house. Well, Dustin Taylor had a very good semi-final, but... hang on. Just going to go and have a confab with the side referee. Well, our side referee is saying it was good. Did have a little look at the guy. He was... referee colleague who was in charge of the timing, not his job. I think it's going to stand as a red, is it? No, it's gone. Oh, I just got. Jay Waldron. You don't know what to do. Got a hoodie under his United States t-shirt. That's how chilly it is. So four greens for Korda after the interjection of Marion Carbonari. And We're just getting the targets back into some kind of sync here. Taylor ready to take to the station. A little bit stop start, the start to this final. And we're a little bit later than advertised. In terms of the schedule today, it's taken a while, but we've got there. And it's been enthralling all the way through. And it was worth the wait for Dustin Taylor. Just one miss, that from Eric Fatini, the man who didn't miss much. Well, just once in the semi-final. Round we go. There are darker clouds just drifting across. The weather is coming from over our left shoulder, and we're in a little bus shelter, so we can't really see over our left shoulder. So if it rains, it rains. We're okay. We're undercover. The referee isn't. All the athletes. No problems for Fatini or Kallionen. What about Korte, the German? Oh. You see the effort and the concentration and the speed of thought and action you need. So just the one miss from Korte. Round we go to station five. It's the Italian and will get us underway. Eric Fatini. I wonder how he will feel. Inexperienced. Certainly when it comes to the men's competition, being in a final, well, certainly in a semi-final before, but this is something slightly different. That's better. Just the one miss from him. That's not bad. You take that, I think. Certainly in these conditions. Kallionen, the other youngster. 24 and 25. Kallionen, the 24-year-old. Looking equally at home here on the top table of sports shooting. We didn't enjoy that miss there, either he or his coach. Fatini and Kallionen, both with one miss. The German already with one miss. Room in the final. We have 20 targets before we decide who takes fourth. Nicely done. 3 on 9. Can Dustin Taylor squeak ahead by one? Long and very positive shout of Paul. Shout whatever you want, as long as the microphone can pick it up. I think a miss from the low house. Yeah, a little look over his shoulder from the referee to the side referee. So, as I used to say in the old days, not a cigarette paper to put between them. I don't think we can say that anymore, so we'll just say it's very tight. 9 apiece. And one more time around, and then we will lose an athlete we know, then we who will be on the podium. It's just working out in what position. And it's very finely balanced. almost in at different points throughout this first rotation around, and the coach right on hand as Patini walks back to give his opinion. Good start from Kalliainen. Now then, if you can with regularity hit this reverse from the high house, you're in with a chance. And another miss. Same shot. Quarter now with a chance to sneak ahead. Now's the time to find a continuation of the form, and the high house eludes Quarter as well. Oh, Dustin Taylor, will you like to take advantage of the reds from the others? That's a miss from the low house. Yeah, it was curling away. It took the wind, I think. So Taylor with these two to keep himself level with everybody else. No problems. To the middle, to station four, and to Patini. It was Sven Korte who missed last time round at this station. Still in contention. Just missing out on a medal, Kalliainen in Tokyo. Taylor to keep himself level as we get to a nail-biting fifth station. Well, we have to wait a bit. There's no target there. Joe Aldrin very rarely without his shades, but it's dark enough to take them off here. The athletes have the light enhancing shades. They'll keep those on. And that was a miss on a second target there. So Dustin Taylor at a slight disadvantage. Well, a huge disadvantage, but it might be crucial. If everybody else scores four, then you are on your way. Bib number against him as well, bib number four. Just got a nibble. Just got a nibble off that one. That came out of the low house, but it was enough. Every target counts. Very tight at the moment. The Finnish coach happy to keep smiling. He hits another two here. He's through and got a medal. Congratulations. You never know, possibly a bonus amongst the coaches. It may be that for once the United States drop out. up to Sven Korte here. Took his time on the one from the high house. Two here, and Taylor is shut out. Oh, that's a miss. But it's okay, because he has the higher bib number. Little smile and nod from the German coach. So Dustin Taylor will want to finish this one off in style. Just about got the low house target. Little glance from the referee to his side referees. Finish as well, but not well enough. Little glance across at the scoreboard from Dustin Taylor, the man from Fort Benning, the army man. We'll have to make his way back towards the coach. Fourth place for him. Fine margins, really fine margins in this excellent final. Well, Pettini, Kallioninen, Korte, it's an all-European podium. But who will be on what step? We're underway again to find out who will take third, who will take bronze. 10 more targets. Once more around these three shooting stations. Kept high from the high house, but was dealt with nicely. See how dark it is now by how bright those lights are on the microphones. Couldn't see that, of course, in the start of the proceedings when we started the women's competition 3 hours and a bit ago. Nice from Kallioninen. Well, the pressure's on Korte. It could be. And, battle of the 20-year-olds. No, further behind. Was that another miss? Yes, it was. Oh, dear. Well, he's a long way behind now. A long way to claw back. And the other two athletes also have to remember to keep themselves focused. No problems for Pettini. Jet just makes its way overhead, I think, probably heading into Larnaca. Hand goes up, no problem, says the referee. I saw it. So, Korte still behind on the podium, but will it be the bronze? We'll find out after this station. Pettini has been excellent all throughout this competition. Well, Kallioninen this beyond quarter. These two in a great battle, and it's left quarter trailing in their wake. So the bronze medal going to the German. Another miss further behind. Can he finish with a couple of greens in his column? Yes, he can. So it is the German Sven Korte, the 33-year-old soldier by profession and a bronze medalist here. And he's pretty happy with that. And there's confirmation. Korte takes the bronze, but we have a very good battle, don't we, for gold and silver here. Neck and neck. Here we go then. Buckle up for the denouement here. Good start from Patini. Just a couple of misses from him so far. Nice, good concentration in what is pretty gloomy conditions at the moment. There you are, like two heavyweights in the ring, slugging it out, toe to toe. And they are in excellent form, no problems with that high house that we always talk about. The two coaches getting a bit exasperated by the delays, but we are getting ever closer to finding out who will take this title. Will it be a shoot-off in the end? You wouldn't put it past these two, would you? He's living every single bit of this. Leonin has been the nearly man. Fourth in Tokyo, World Championships, fifth in Lenato. Back in 2015, that's in the junior championships. These two have been slugging it out. Well, here we go, Kalionen. What pressure, will he take it to a shoot off? Oh, and there's a miss. There's a miss, and that at last breaks it between these two, and it is the Italian who will take the gold, and Itu Kalionen will get onto the podium with the silver.
Kalionen, up to from Finland, is second place and silver medalist with 35 hits. Congratulations to all three winners of this medal match.
Wonderful scenes from Eric Patini.
This Hitman event.
Massive first individual World Cup gold. And Kallionen, well, you've got to be pleased for him as well. A silver for him. And, well, it's gloomy, but these three will light up the stage.
From Germany.
These are the three.
In second place,
Sven Korte taking the bronze. It's Eetu Kallionen of Finland with the silver. And well, well done to Eric Patini, his first World Cup individual gold.
From Italy. In a few minutes, we will have the award ceremony up on the cafeteria area outside where is the podium.
Wonderful stuff. They've been enjoying watching the highlights with us, and well, Eric what is it? I don't know what they're up to, but Eric basically doesn't speak much English. I don't speak much Italian, so we've got Chiara to help to translate. But first of all, congratulations. How do you feel?
Come ti senti?
Stanco, molto stanco e finalmente realizzato. Perché,
he's very tired, but he's happy. He's very happy now.
It took a long time. It got very dark. Was it difficult out there?
Era difficile con il tempo brutto così scuro.
Sì, di che era faceva fatica a vederli. Infatti ho dovuto rallentare su tutti I piattelli, sennò non riuscivo a sparare come al solito.
He was not easy because it was very dark. So he has to get slow on some targets and not shoot very fast as he usually do.
And it was very tight. It was a very nervous ending. How did he feel, you know, that he coped with that?
Come ti sei sentito alla fine che eravate vicini vicini e avete lottato fino alla fine?
Alla fine me la son goduta tutta. Ho detto vada come vada, però sparo do il 100% e vado al meglio che posso. E sono riuscito a vincere.
He tries to enjoy until the end and he tries to do 100% what he can do and he made it.
First individual World Cup gold, so a big party tonight.
Una festa stasera, la prima Coppa del Mondo
yes.
che vinci.
È la seconda che partecipo.
It's the second World Cup he makes in his life, in the first World Cup fifth place, and now he won, so he's very happy.
Well, congratulations, grazie mille, and enjoy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hope you've enjoyed our finals as well. We've got the mixed team tomorrow, of course, so hope you can join us for that. But for today, from here in Cyprus, bye bye.